You keep hearing the word pressure and must win. Mm-hmm. How do you guys handle those terms, and how do you make it work?
Well, we've been here before. It's not the first time we've been in this position, fighting for a playoff spot. So it's like it's a new season of doing the same thing. This team has seen it all, the ups and the downs. So, you know, right now we're just in a period where we are in a must-win situation. And every week is a playoff game for us.
Do you care anything about the weather, the stadium, or anything about special about being in Green Bay?
I love playing at Lambeau just because it's a legendary field. But the weather, it shouldn't be a factor because it's football at the end of the day. And it's those type of conditions you kind of want because it makes it more of a football atmosphere.
You guys earned your way back to the top of the NFC South. You control that thing now. But You look at the situation, still four games to go. You can't take an exhale here.
Yeah, no. It's like I said, it's like a playoff game every game because you never know how these things may end up. You may end up, head-to-head with another NFC team who has a good record. Atlanta could still win out or there's so many different scenarios that could happen. So it's just in our best to just win out and control our own destiny.
You like that pressure?
I love it. It's like, it makes you want to play harder and to know that you're playing for something bigger than just like a win. You're playing for a playoff spot.
Could I ask you to Antoine Winfield having just a year where he's been great since he's gotten here, but he's elevated his game even.
Yeah, for sure.
Since Brian Dawkins in 2002 to have more than 3 sacks, forced fumbles, and fumble recoveries.
Yeah. Yo, he's been playing so great this year, man. He's really upped his level. Like you said, he's always been a good player for us, but like this year, he's a great player. This year, he's just doing everything he told me he would do before the season. Proud of him. His routine is really consistent, man. He's a consistent guy, and he's definitely one of the best safeties in the league right now.
He said he made a mistake on the Kyle Pitts touchdown, kind of some confusion there against Atlanta. But to turn around after a play like that that gives him a touchdown and come up with a safety was critical in that match.
Yeah, I mean, that's just the type of guy he is, man. He's a accountable guy, but at the same time, he's a guy that looks forward to the next play. He's always looking to make another play, man. I love playing with him. As a safety, it's good to have somebody who you can really depend on back there with you. So that's just the type of guy he is, man. He's a next play kind of guy, but he's a player that once he – and it's not even his fault. We can't even just sit here and say it's his fault. It was just a bust in the coverage, miscommunication on everybody's end. So it's just not on him. We got to do a better job of just, being on the same page, everybody, not just him, not just me, just everybody in the back end. So, he's going to take accountability for it, but I can say the same. So,
is he a better pass rusher or interceptor?
So I don't know. He's an all-around guy. This guy does it all. He tackles. He makes plays on the ball. He creates fumbles. He can pass rush. He can do everything. I don't know anything he can't do.
Thanks, Carlton. Appreciate it.
No problem.